नित्यानंदेश्वर समारंभां नित्यानंदेश्वरी मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, srimahans, mahans, kotaris, tanedars, sitting with us all over the world in Rajya Sabha Bidadi and through Nityananda TV, Sadhana TV, two-way video conferencing, having Nayanadiksha, all over the world. The city is sitting with us all over the world having Nayanadiksha. Jorpatti, Nepal, Kulim, Tiruttani, Belgium, Dhyanapeetam, Guadalupe, Rameshwaram, Dakota, Dunes, Scottsdale, Arizona, Hyderabad, Guptakashi, San Jose, Madurai, Vancouver, Canada, Hyderabad, Bahyanagaram, many more cities, Seattle, Chidambaram. I'll read out later on more and more when they join, when I'm able to see them. Now with this, I welcome all of you with my love and respects. Today I'll expand on the space of completion and the space of Sangha. Please listen. Yesterday I was explaining one of the very important truth of Advaita. How anything we don't want to see only becomes our ignorance. There's no such thing as we can't see. Understand? Anything we don't want to see only becomes our ignorance. But there's no such thing as we can't see. Your consciousness allowed to see without incompletion can penetrate and see anything. Listen, anything your consciousness is allowed to see without incompletions, it can penetrate and see. Understand? Last 2-3 days, maybe I think 4 days, one day in between break, totally last 3 days, we were driving in and around Bangalore. I was accepting Pada Puja in many devotees' house. even in some board they have used any of our temple deity picture. I'll tell them, hey, this is our Los Angeles Venkateshwara, this is our Seattle Nataraja. The Mahans and Srimahans were with me. Especially one of the Mahant is newly getting to spend time around me. He never spent time around me this close quarters. He was shocked because there was a vehicle going with our flag, six flag. Two was not fully visible. Two flags were shrunk, four were fully visible. I told them, call and tell them two were not fully visible. It was only flash. The Mahant could not understand how I can see so much continuously. Please understand. You all have the incompletions about wanting, not wanting. Some things you like and some things you don't like. Some things you want and some things you don't want. That is why when you are hungry, you will see all the hotel boards. When you are tired, you will see all the boarding places, boards. In India, hotel is the name used for both. I can say, when you are hungry, you will see all the restaurant boards. When you are tired, want to sleep, you will see all the hotels and largest boards. When you are full in the stomach, even if there is a huge McDonald's tower, you won't even cognize it. Even if there is a huge restaurant board, you won't even cognize it. When you are feeling urgent to rush to the bathroom, you will see everything will be fall in your eyes, which possibly as a restroom. Now you need to understand this very seriously. The pressure in the body decides what you see. Your desire and fear decides what you see, which is completely wrong. If you free your consciousness from desires and fears, from all the incompletions, it can see simply everything. When it sees everything, you can give the option of inform me whenever I see all these. Understand? You can use your ability to see with options. You can always give options. For your ability to see. But don't give options for your consciousness by putting incompletions on it. Listen, there is two different things. Listen. If you put incompletions on you in the form of desire and fear, your ability to see itself will be drastically reduced. It is like when you are not hungry, no restaurant board will fall in your eyes. Your ability to see itself is reduced. Don't do that. Keep yourself in the space of completion. See everything. Perceive everything. And You can give a choice. You can tag all these things. If it comes, alert me. Do not put the instrument itself in powerlessness because you want only little information for your day-to-day life. Please understand. In your day-to-day life, all the time seeing restaurants, hotels, lodges is not useful for you. But that does not mean you will reduce your power to see everything. Please understand, you have 1,000-acre land. You are going to use only 100 acres. That does not mean all the remaining 900 acres, you will destroy it. You will make it useless. No. Let the whole 1,000 acres be useful, available to you. Let this 100 be used by you. When you bring the fear or desire into your cognition, your ability to see itself is drastically reduced. Not only that, your powerlessness is exploited. For example, in India you will see all hoardings, whether it is a soap or jewelry or sari or car or bank loan, it will only be with female model. Why men don't take bank loan? Men don't drive car. Same way in US, whether it is a housing loan or medicine or advertisement for depression medication or whatever it may be, it will only be with dogs and kids. Because this country is, India is sexually repressed, US is relationship poverty. Psychologically deep unfulfillment. Sex is available everywhere, but relationships are not available. That is why kids and dogs become so important in their lifestyle. Here so much of relationships are available, means brother, father, mother, everything is available, but sex is rare commodity. That is why here everything has to be with sexual paint. Powerlessness in any form can be exploited. Understand, powerlessness in any form can be exploited. In India, even this concept of putting silver, silk, gold, diamond on deities and on gurus, all this also in a way to get your attention. Indians' eyes, they cannot take their eyes away from gold and diamond. Silk, gold and diamond, they cannot take their eyes away. That is why we put that on deities. I know how many minds it is going on. Wow, Swamiji is having big 2 Rudrakshmala today, new. Listen. Seeing is not wrong, but making your incompletions as the decision making factor to see what to see and what not to see is wrong. Let your incompletions not decide what you will see and what you will not see. That is where the problem starts. Listen. Please understand. Arrogance means your incompletions deciding and interpreting the existential reality. Your incompletions deciding and interpreting the existential reality is arrogance. Your existential reality interpreting existential reality being interpreted by your incompletions is arrogance. When your incompletions decide what you see and what you don't see, the reality is being interpreted by your incompletions. That is what I call arrogance. Even if you act humble, you will be acting humble. And you don't need to be humble, I am telling you. Humbleness is a stupid, very stupid value promoted by society to exploit you. Neither be arrogant nor be humble. Just be real. Reality is so beautiful. I have seen stinking humble fellows. Means inside they will be stinking with arrogance. And outside they will be, Swamiji, you are God, you are great, I am here at your feet, I have surrendered myself to you. I tell them, okay, please take up the responsibility of Kothari and do. No, I am too much work, I cannot do anything. Then what do you mean by the word of the surrender? I have surrendered to you? Do not allow the incompletions to interpret your reality. Understand? When J. Krishnamurti says freedom from the known, that is what he means. Freedom from all the known which has happened through incompletions. Freedom from all the known which has happened through incompletions. Listen, I'll give you one difference. It's a very high philosophical point. If you just cognize, you will be freed from so many confusions, because all your good and bad, right and wrong is in your seeing. When your incompletions interfere into the root of your seeing process, you will become arrogant. I am not telling you have to see everything, you have to cognize everything, no. But let the seeing itself is not interfered. Means information flowing into you not be blocked or stopped by your incompletions. The information you handle and make decisions, only that be tagged by your interests and wants and needs. For example, if 1,000 information available around you, 1,000 billboard available, all 1,000 should be seen by you, perceived by you. That should not be stopped. But information processing in your system, cognizing in your thinking, that can be only what you need, what is your interest. Program yourself for your interests, but don't deny anything else as part of life. Unfortunately, other than your interest, you deny the whole thing existentially. That is why most of the time you don't see anything, you don't enjoy anything which you don't feel as yours. I have seen people, even if they go to Ooty, Kodaikanal, they will never enjoy that whole Ooty and Kodaikanal. They will enjoy only their flat. Stupid fellow, if you are going to enjoy only your flat or house, better you be in your open air prisons. Last few days I am visiting continuously in Bangalore. All these flats, open air prisons. You could have been just stuck with your open air prisons. Understand, your decision in cognition, your decision allowing information is very important for you to feel fulfilled. I tell you, when everything is available to you and you choose, you feel you are a king. But your incompletions stop the information available to you, you feel beggar, poor. I tell you, I have seen filthy rich people. I don't even need to use two words. I'm really telling you, they will have their own villas, houses in every beach in the world, every resort, every hilly regions in the world, but they will be so stupid in their cognition, they will be able to enjoy only what they feel as theirs due to their incompletions of desire and greed, desire and fear. Even if they have 2,000 beach houses, still they will be go on feeling suffocated and poor. I tell you, this is what is the root of the mechanism. Listen to the root of the mechanism. Me seeing all the billboards in the street, but cognizing only few, you not even seeing due to your desire and fear blocking your cognition. These two need to be analyzed and understood. Then you will understand the real issue, experience of richness and poverty. Even when I was begging in the streets without having a penny and not knowing where the next meal is, I know for sure I am the universe. Because my senses were sharp and never blocked and stopped by incompletions of mine and not mine. The Isavasya Upanishad second verse beautifully explains, Tena Tyaktena Vunjita Makrita Kasya Swiddhanam. It means, renounce everything and enjoy everything. As long as you have the idea, this is mine and this is not mine, you will never enjoy everything available and you will go on be suffering with the suffocation. The man who's renounced the idea of desire and fear, mine and not mine, the man who has renounced the filter system, stops informations into his cognition due to fear and greed, is the Lord of the universe. He is sannyasi. He is jivan mukta. Tena tyaktena punjita makrita kasya sviddhanam. The first teaching of the first Upanishad of the first Veda is Ishavashyam itam sarvam. Whatever exists is energy, God. Tena tyaktena punjita makrita kasya sviddhanam. Drop your small filtering mechanism of desire and fear. Which decides what you own and what you don't own. When you drop that incompletion mechanism, you know everything is yours. You perceive everything. You listen everything. You are so available. Life is so available. You are available to life. Life is available to you. Then in that powerfulness, you can have your own choice system. For example, 10 tray of food is there. You are going to eat only one tray. But don't put dirt in all the other 9 tray. And don't pollute it. Let all the 10 be there, available to you. You pick up and eat only one tray. But we are so violent. Anything we don't want to enjoy, we corrupt it and block it. Stop this habit of blocking your cognition by desire and fear and incompletions. If you just do completion on what all you are blocking due to your incompletions in the life, I guarantee in a month you will not need a spectacles or hearing aid. I am telling this to all my disciples who are wearing spectacles. Understand? It is a damage you did to your eyes because of your incompletions interfering in your seeing. Sit and think through every night. Do completion as much as you can. Dig out, dig out, dig out. We can have 21 day chashma samyama. Chashma samyama. Or chakshu samyama. Really, I'm telling you. Don't allow this incompletion. You see, sometime, if you don't attend the fat in your body for 4-5 years, it becomes a permanent damage in the heart After that, even if you reduce your cholesterol, the damage cannot be reversed. Same way, if you allow the incompletions for too long, you will have a permanent damage in the eyes. Then after that, even if you complete these incompletions, you cannot reverse damage done to the eyes. That is why I am telling you, start now. Start your completions with your eyes now. Your ability to see today. Then you may not allow the permanent damages in your eyes. You can, even if there are one or two damages happened, it can be reversed. And ultimately, if you keep your cholesterol low, for 5-6 years, the damage done to the heart can be reversed. Same way, if you keep your incompletions complete for 3-4 years, the damage done to your body can be reversed and healed. Go and tell Kalabhairava, all the known incompletions I commit with you, I will complete. All the unknown incompletions is your responsibility. I am surrendering to you. And I tell you, he really, really, really responds and completes. Whenever you ask him to bring completion to you, he is embodiment of compassion. Whenever you associate you with the incompletions, he is the terror. Which side you are standing only decides whether he is terror or compassionate being. He is the most compassionate if you are standing on the side of the completion. He is the ultimate terror if you are standing on the side of the incompletion. He can show the extra teeth and the smile both. He can show the terror teeth and the smile both. He is the only God capable of that. Two terror teeth and the wide smile. If you associate yourself with completion, he has such a sweet smile for you. If you associate yourself with the incompletion, he has such a terror teeth for you. The terror teeth will grind even universes and swallow. The smile can create even universes for you. Always have this agreement with Kalabhairava. All the incompletions you make me known, I commit with you, I'll complete them. I am responsible for it. All the incompletions unknown to me, you are responsible for it. And I tell you, he always agrees for this agreement because he is teaching you this agreement. He always agrees for this agreement. All the incompletions known to me, I am responsible. I'll complete them. I'll drop them. I'll complete and drop them. I'll never allow them into my cognition. But there are many unknown to me. I cannot do anything about it. That you are responsible. I tell you, he is the most sweetest God. He is the most sweetest God. He is the Lord of completion. He can heal any incompletion. Not only heal, he can just make any incompletion irrelevant. He can just make them irrelevant to your life and you. Means you will even forget you had incompletion in that area at one time is time, kala, lot of time. So go and tell him, all the incompletions I have about my vision, my seeing, which is known to me, I am responsible. I'll dig them out, dig them out, dig them out, and complete and drop. Whatever is not known to me, you are responsible, complete them. Or make them known to me, so that I can complete. Either I should be Lord of life or you should be Lord of life. No third person in between you and me. That's all. Either I should be or you should be. No unknown zone, no blind spot between you and me. Not having blind spot between you and Guru is surrender. Not having blind spots between you and Kalabhairava is authenticity. No blind spots. Either for all this I am responsible and I am completing it, and whatever is not known within my framework, you are responsible, you are completing it. But ultimately we are neither going to have known incompletion nor going to allow unknown incompletion. That's all. Neither known incompletion nor unknown incompletion. Both will not be allowed. Everyone who has spectacles or contact lens, today tell Kalabhairava, go and sit and talk to him. Our Bidhi Kalabhairava will simply talk back to you. You don't even need to talk for him. You just go and talk to him, you will see, he will answer. You will simply listen the answer in his own voice. You don't need to say, how you do in the temples, oh God, please save me. And then you talk for the God also. Oh my son, don't worry, I am here, I will protect you. For our Kalabhairava, you don't need to talk back. You just say, oh Mahadeva, please protect me. He will say, hey, what you are trying to act here? Complete with all this incompletion, others I will take care. He will talk to you in his voice. Is Swayam Prakasa. And alive. So listen. Let your perception not be corrupted, made to be impure. Having choices is not wrong, but corrupting the other part which you think you don't need is wrong. Or limiting yourself due to your choices is wrong. So understand. And liberate yourself. Understand and liberate yourself. I bless you all. And commit with you all. Kalabhairava will complete you. Just go and tell him, all my unknown incompletions, you are responsible. Known, whatever you made me known, I am responsible. Start with this agreement. You will see, he simply completes you and liberates you. I bless you all. Let you all achieve complete completion and radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching and causing eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
நித்யானந்த தியான பீட்டம், நித்யானந்த நகர், ஆஃப் மைசூர் ரோட், பிடதி, பெங்களூரு. ஃபோன் 080-272-7999. www.nityananda.org. www.youtube.com/lifebliss foundation.